today. Let's see if it does. Oh, I've already got like 1,000 drop frames. Howdy, howdy. How are you guys doing? Just making sure this is all working here with the stream. Oh man, my internet's been such a big problem. It's caused me a lot of stress. Hard-boiled egg, cool name, man. Finally caught a stream. What's up? Hey, welcome. Boogie, what's up? Oh, cool. So awesome. The video seems okay. Wait a minute. That's wrong. This should never be 2,000. I got. So I'm trying to get my. What's up, Azarus? I got my settings. I'm trying to figure this out. This is set right. Yeah, it's got a max bit rate. This is my lower settings. I don't know if you guys can read code today. Let's see if you can read the code. Is this readable? You can read the text? Oh, good. Nice. Well, yeah, that's all that really matters. I'm trying to make it so you guys can at least read the code, but it's still, it should be outputting much lower bit rate too, so it might even be better for you guys to watch this way anyways. So yeah, let's cross your fingers that this freaking works. It's fuzzy but readable. Okay, all right. It's because I'm at a slightly lower resolution streaming right now, so I'm streaming at like 960 max height instead of 1080 or something like that. I forget. And then I said some max bit rate things. Okay, so let's just hope it works. Man, yeah, like I'm saying, dude, it's been causing me stress with the freaking internet lately. Yeah, cool, I'm glad you like the new update. There's so many bugs to fix, and I'm gonna get into fixing those right now. That's also causing me a lot of stress. I'm kind of burnt out, actually, guys, so I don't know how long this stream will last today. But, yeah, I'm gonna just fix as many bugs as I can. Let's get the Trello open as well. Let me close that. You beat all the dungeons? Oh, Boogie! Dude, how was it? How was it? Was it difficult? Was it too easy? Oh, also I published a new an update to the Windows version today, so hopefully it should be full screen again for you guys. But it still has a problem. When you try and run it in windowed full screen mode, it switches into, it removes the title bar after it creates the window, and there's no way I can get around that. So I did the best I could to try and get it so there's the least amount of letterboxing possible. But basically that's probably the first thing I should fix right now, is this setting the default to be full screen. On level one, the door won't open. Yeah, the full screen thing's already been being worked on. What about level one, door won't open? Do you have a key? You need keys to open doors. Your game crashed just before the stream started? Are you playing the Songbringer? It was pretty difficult at parts? Ah, yeah. Nice! You beat them. Yeah, the Roz ones? Yeah, those are pretty hard, huh? Wow, dude! So how long was your game? Oh no, what? Okay, so where did Songbringer crash for you? Huh. First bugs first. I think that this default should be full screen. I hope this doesn't crash the stream or anything, but if I run the game in full screen on Mac, that's my primary concern. There was one time, 5 hours, nice. You're at the boss in level 5 dungeon. Hard-boiled egg, were you using any crafted bombs? Did you have like a Did you have like the fire bombs or the lightning bombs or anything like that? Because I've noticed a bug there too. Like it's crashing the game when there's when those bugs are being when those are being used. Oh, it did work. Didn't it? Let's see. Was that full screen? Totally. That's kind of cool. I guess full screen mode does work. So a lot of bugs to be fixed here today. Right now I can't even get out of this dungeon, but yeah, it looks like it is full screen. Okay, that's good. I'm confident I can change the default from full windowed mode to full screen. So that people won't have the bug next time. Here, where's the defaults? Here we go. Window size is gonna be from now on is gonna be defaulted to full screen. You had the fear bombs. Ah, okay, hard-boiled egg. I think it might have been that. Yeah. And if you want to get rid of that bug in your save game, hard-boiled egg, you can just go to your save game and then turn off your fear bombs. I know it kind of su would suck to uncraft them or whatever, but you would just go to it would say like fear bomb one, and you would just change it to fear bomb zero, and then you wouldn't get that bug anymore. Or just not don't use your bombs. Sorry about that. But yeah, I'll get that fixed. So let me actually that should be noted. That's a pretty important bug. And I've been meaning to note that. So crafted bombs crash. It's like it's not green, that's red. Yeah, it just needs more bosses, right. Enjoy the hammer guy. Yeah, okay, good. That's the intention. The intention is to have every one of the bosses actually a unique boss enemy, and then all the switch rooms will be full of crazy mobs. So good. I'm glad for that feedback. Thanks, Woogie. What's Quexlore about? It's an old game I wrote in conjunction with a bunch of other people. It's an RPG. Yeah, right. Okay, good. I'm glad. Oh, okay, good. Good feedback, you guys. I'm glad about that. Knowing about bosses being, it'd be cool if bosses weren't just these total mobs. So for now, should I change it so the bosses are always just either the Drop guy or the Blob guy? Or do you like, or should I keep it how it is right now? So there's a few mobs, and there's the like the those guys until I get the other bosses written. And also, if anybody has the game right now, it would be super cool to know if I fixed it, if I fixed the full screen on Windows thing. Yeah. So that, yeah. I understand they're cool for the switch rooms. But I was wondering if I should keep the boss rooms having mobs at all, or if they should I should just switch it. So basically, there's like nine different boss rooms, right, in the world. Should they just be drop boss bob drop blob drop blob, just repeating all of the drops and bobs, or should they still have the mobs for now? Oh, cool. The full screen does work now? Oh, that's great. Oh, thank you guys. That's to be a cool one to check off the list for now. It's not going to be as full screen as the full screen mode, but it will hopefully be better. And it won't hopefully it won't have any kind of like your taskbar showing through or anything. What's up, the Robo dude? Just fixing some bugs in the latest alpha version. So for this whole week, I've had to. For free, like half a week now, I've had Stormbringer out on Steam as a alpha update so people can play it, but it's not official, right? So I'm just letting everybody play it first and then fixing all as many bugs as I can. And so then this Wednesday, there's going to be an official alpha update release. And actually, there's a date for the beta as well. So the beta release is going to be February 21st. So that's what's up, Rubba Dude. I'm just going to start fixing some bugs. Let's see, has Game Show been running all right? It looks like it has, huh? All right, well, I mean, yeah, it's working. Cool. All right, so I'm gonna start fixing bugs, and I kind of gotta fix something else before I start fixing bugs, actually. I changed some code yesterday that's gotta be finished before I can really fix anything. Let me make sure. Yeah, that's good. Default window size is full screen. Window size full works. Yay, yay, yay. That's one down. All right, I'm archiving this one. Sweet. Okay. Yes, that feels so good to have at least one. Yeah, there's good. Yeah, that's like I said, there's gonna be a black bar at the top. And if you want to get rid of that black bar, just set your window size to be full screen. It looks like this. So you would change your instead of it saying window size full like this, you would just say full screen. And eventually I'll get this hooked up so it's actually in the menu and you can change your window size. But for now, just change that to full screen instead of full, and you'll be good to go. Boogie has no letterboxing? Oh, good. So the code does work on some systems. Yes, because you're on Windows 10, right? Yeah, because on my Windows 7, it still has letterboxing. Scottish Pizza still has letterboxing. What version of Windows are you on, Scottish Pizza? The Robo Dude, no, I'm not using any scripting languages. Unless you count my own custom like behavior, which I guess are kind of scripting languages. But no, I'm not using JavaScript, I'm not using any kind of like Lua or any scripts. When your Windows 10. Oh, but your display is 16 by 9. It's really lagging for you? Is it really lagging for you now that you changed it to full screen or something? Or why might it be lagging? Okay, so I gotta go into area creation where it's creating entities. I changed the way entities are working. So in the game, instead of it being every all the entities in world.txt, now all the entities are actually in entities.txt. So I'm in the process of moving entities from world.txt here into entities. So that basically an entity, like for example, a water entity can be in every kind of level if it wants to be, you know, like it could be in every kind of dungeon. And then this at character will work to put the style code in. Full screen can be slow on unsupported resolutions. Really? God damn, maybe I shouldn't make the default full screen then. It's because you were in a spider room? Yeah, that makes me nervous to do full screen, actual full screen mode. Oh, I guess I'll leave it for now. Hopefully no one complains about any lag or anything. Well, the good news is full screen should be a supported resolution because it should, I mean it should, I can't imagine why it would not create it in a supported resolution. It's using GLFW. GLFW is pretty, you know, pretty well mature. Okay, going back here, I'm gonna go to anywhere that loads from entity. Actually, I'm gonna start with the entrance tile. Alright, so if this is a level, it's going to be world get entity data for entrance dungeon. Full screen is faster than windowed when using a resolution that's the GPU can handle natively, though. Ah, good. Well, I hope that. I would assume that GLFW and Cocos 2DX would be using a native friendly resolution. But that's, of course, not guaranteed. All right, so if it's a underground entrance, it's gonna be entrance underground percent D. But otherwise, it's gonna be entrance percent D given this flag number. Yeah, button to show FPS. I think there is a setting already. Let's see if it's see if I made that. Yeah, that should work actually. Get bool setting. Debug only, I believe, is a by default false. Yes, okay, that'll work. So in your settings, you can just go like this and set show FPS to 1. And it should have some rudimentary FPS data. So yeah, so it's not a button, but at least you can turn that on. And I think draw debug might even work too. Like if you were to go draw debug 2, I think would set it. Let's see. I think draw debug is also a friendly. Yeah, it looks like it is. Yeah, you could use draw debug as well. So, but show FPS is probably going to be the simpler way to do it. But draw debug would look like this. It would go. The Steam FPS counter? What's the Steam FPS counter? Does Steam have their own like overlay or something? Yeah, there's a lot of Steam features I haven't even implemented yet. But oh yeah, this would work too. So you can set draw debug to 2 or 3. You're not actually gonna be able to toggle it like I can in debug mode, but at least you could turn it on and then run your game and you would have this kind of information. This would be debug level 3 here. Debug level 0 is like that. Debug level 1 is like this. Debug level 2 is like this. And then 3 is like this. So you could just set debug level 2 to get the frame rate up there. So there's two ways to do that. Actually, debug level 2 is pretty nice because then it also shows you what area you're in. So you could know your area number for reporting bugs and stuff. Okay, so yeah, I'm working on fixing some bugs, but first I gotta fix some other stuff I introduced yesterday. What's up? Welcome to the stream, Timothy. So I'm creating an entrance tile. Looks like, oh, this might actually be fixed already. Yeah, so that should be fun to play with. I hope it works for you. I'm pretty sure it does. It should be allowed to run in debug mode and all that. Yeah, that looks good. Just turn debug off now. Oh, the Steam FPS counter used to work, but not anymore. Are you talking about Steam in general or Steam FPS counter with Songbringer? Yeah, leaving this saves as plain text is awesome. Yeah, especially for now, right? I might, when I actually finally release the game, I think if I might actually have to encode all that, you know, like make it, I might make it simple, like even just Base64 or something like that, so you could easily hack it if you wanted. But that'll just keep, you know, some script kiddies from trying to mess with stuff. Oh, good. So yeah, this entrance is working. Oh, it's okay. So it used to work with Songbringer, huh? Huh. I wonder why it wouldn't would or wouldn't do that. You know, the really the only thing I changed recently with the with it was disable VSync. You might want to try that. Like you can go, just add this option, disable VSync 1, and your FPS counter might work. I don't know. That's really the only thing I've changed. You know what? No, one of the other things, one of the other things I did change recently was I upgraded to CocoStudioX 3.9, which may have changed a lot with how it interacts with Steam. I don't know. Hmm. Would bat programming be a good thing to learn first? You mean like batch files? Not really. I mean, if you're talking about batch files, it depends on what you want to use it for, right? If you just want to be a, if you want to be like a system administrator for Windows, then a batch files would be a good thing to learn. If you want to make games though, or if you want to make software in general, not just scripting, then batch files are probably not the best thing to learn. Batch files are totally different than any other operating system. You know, for most operating systems, for Linux and for most system administration things, you're going to be using shell scripts, which are .sh or whatever you want to call them. They're like, they look like this, you know, this is a tiny little script, just converts a file. But yeah, what is it that you want to do, Timothy? What do you want to learn? What do you want to eventually become? Okay, I want to test level 2 to make sure its entrance is also working. Okay, good. Good. Oh, bad. So this should be an entrance right here. I wonder if... Yeah, it's totally missing. Okay, save here. Let's figure out why that's working. You just want to make a short, simple game? Okay, then I would definitely not recommend learning batch file programming. If you want to make a short, simple game, I would start with Game Maker or maybe Pygame or something really easy and simple like that. You know, even like Quick Basic. Oh, well. It's because we need to go world get level here, or that was get level. Maybe it's constants get level. There it is, area pause.z. Or love2d, yeah. There's also construct. Construct is a simple one. Unity, yeah, Unity's a great one too, of course, but it's a little more advanced. So if you're just looking to make a simple game, it might not be your easiest solution. Entrance underground. Maybe I spelled this wrong or something. Oh, you lost it? Damn. It sucks losing your first games. I lost my first game too. I spent a whole year on it. It's lost somewhere in one of my hard drives. I don't know. That was 1995, so it's been a long time. It would be entities actually. All right, so we got entrance dungeon 1, entrance 1. Oh, it's because I'm not even. I didn't move the right entity. Okay, first things first. Got to move all these entities. Overworld, ground, flags, entities, idea tile, idea bush. No. All right, water, mountain, pillar, light pillar. Yeah, all these. All these belong in here now. Less indenting. Oh, so good, so good. Adventure capitalist, nice. Yeah, space chickens, that's the one. It's probably on a floppy disk, right? Yep. I miss floppy disks. I kind of wish my computer had a floppy disk. Can you imagine a modern day laptop having a floppy disk? Like a slim style MacBook Pro with the floppy disk opening. All right, so pillar, water, statue, these kinds of things. You just want to make a leveling system where you could gamble your EXP and you gain EXP over time. Cool. Nice, man. Yeah, start with one of those solutions one of those game engines that we were just mentioning there. And remember, oh, check these out too. Check out these videos, Timothy. Even though they're great memories and you gotta go where you today, some of this is a good thing to just, yes, it is good. It is good for some things to disappear. So I shouldn't need these. But this one's good. Actually, all these are good. Hell, even this one's good. The null video, right? Did I spell it wrong? I'm so bad. I'm so bad. Bafu can't do misspelling correction? Nonsense. That would be overkill. Total overkill. Bafu would turn into like Google. Did you mean blah 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 blah? So some of these, water, for example, is a good one to put number. I don't know about that or that or that right now. Or that, but this pillar, this should be number sign. Yes. He doesn't understand. I don't think he should. He's way more bot-like when he doesn't understand our misspellings. All right, I'm making sure all this data is looking good. Water low plus 3, 111B. Yeah, that should be good for any level now. Pillars, let's see. Pillar. At pillar. Oh yeah, at pillar would be better here. That does mean that I need to move pillars to be 0. You can't minimize the song rear window at all. Are you in full screen mode? Or quasi full screen? There's this, there's full, or there's full screen. Full is technically full windowed, right? Full is like full windowed mode. But full screen is fully full screen. Yeah, so what are you full screen or are you full screen windowed? All right, that one looks good too. Pillar, light pillar. Okay, I'm start moving the other entrances. Yeah, borderless, right. That's weird because on my Windows 7 I can alt tab in and out even when it's full screen mode. Huh. Are you trying to alt tab? All right, here's cave. Cave indies. You tried alt tab? Oh man. This is starting to make me think that maybe full screen should not be the default. Gotta think about that. Alright, so we got this rock entity, water entity, that's the same. Pillar entity. We have a light pillar. Unlit pillars. Bender really is the only unique thing in the caves. Yeah, pizza. I just mentioned that. Basically, I've got to hook that all up into the main menu. But yeah, it's already technically in the settings. You just have to change it from full to full screen. Or borderless would be, a good word there. Borderless or... you know, full screen windowed, whatever. Okay, converting entities still. I think these are necessary too. Door and boss door. Haven't hooked those up completely just yet, but those are, I believe, necessary. And these entrances, these are entrances for dungeon 2. So anyway, just joined the stream. Welcome. This is The 296 day making Songbringer. I'm working on fixing bugs for the alpha version coming out. So just kind of, I'm reworking some data for these entities. Okay, let's try that now. Yeah, what stream was that? Okay, let's see if it gets this data this time. Oh yeah, it should. Let's like turn that off. Yes, good. Cool, all right, that's back together. Oh, the light pillars are wrong. Yeah, the mother tree. Oh, that was pretty recent actually. Okay, so I'm just working on getting entities back to how they were. The light pillar is the next thing. The light pillar right there should be a different entity. Light pillar, at pillar number, at pillar glow number. Nice, pizza. I'm glad, man. I'm so glad. And I really hope I hope that it gets a lot better and it becomes something that's even, you know, it's even more of an exciting, fun game to play, because there'll be a lot more bosses. There'll be a lot more world to explore. Nice, pizza. Right on. I really appreciate you saying that. It encourages me. Thank you. And it's sometimes it's a long, long road to make a video game. This is, you know, over a year into making this one, and it's still not even beta. But so it really helps to hear encouraging words like that. So thank you, man. Appreciate it. I need to look in the level. There's something wrong with the light pillar for level 2. Two pillar zero. Oh yeah, it should be working. Light pillar 2 2. All right, maybe it's in area creation actually. All right, so there's a create light pillar tile function. Okay, it gets the right entity data. Oh, it should be formatting fine too. Damn. Okay, I'm gonna set a breakpoint there. It'd be cool if at the end of the game, if you can maybe free roam around the map collecting more things. Yes! Yeah, pizza, you can. You should be able to right now. So what happens is it saves your, you'll have a save game like right before you beat the boss. And I think technically it even saves it right after you beat the boss right now. But you can still roam around your world and get all the way to 100% and then beat it again. And you would technically get a better score on the leaderboard and all that, which is not done yet. There'll be a leaderboard eventually. Okay, so let's see what data. It got the right data. Got children. Everything looks good for its data. But it's processing this image file name wrong. Images.format. What? Let's see that one more time. White Rice, what's up? First time tuning in. Why did you decide to do much of the engine work from scratch as opposed to using Monogame Unity? I did not. I'm using a game engine called Cocos 2DX. And why did I decide to use Cocos 2DX? Because I'm that kind of guy that loves the DIY style game engines. I love C++. I love doing most of things myself. I love having total access to the entire source code. So if anything breaks, I can use it. But it's still, Cocos 2DX is great because it's a cross-platform engine. So I can write all my code once and then deploy it to Windows, Mac, or whatever. Mars of Power, what's up? Mars of Power's in the house. Will you use the Steam names for the leaderboard, or can you create a nickname for the whole game? I'm thinking you could be able to when you every time you beat the game, you would be able to put in a different letter code for your name. Like I'm thinking up to like six letters, kind of like an old school arcade game. So when you beat the game, you input six letters for your leaderboard, and boom, it puts in a different one every time. White rice, does it have good performance? Yes, it does. Coco CX is pretty good. Alex Pita! Nice, thanks for testing. It's so great. Yeah, there's so many bugs already. It's kind of overwhelming. Yeah, I've kind of burnt out, but I'm trying to fix the bugs right now and get as many done as possible before Wednesday. Are you guys doing? How's everything? Bellazio. All right, so it's gonna get this image file name. All right, so it starts with the format pillar number. Oh, there's a problem. What the heck? They're mainly Windows related? I care. Rocket Bunny, what's up, man? You turn off the fear bombs, and the game's now crashing on the Switch room filled with Roz enemies before the boss room. Huh. Oh, that sucks, hard boiled. And is there something going on? Like, what happens right before it crashes? You survived the Russian winter? You've been to St. Petersburg? Whoa, man. Nice. What were you doing there? Yeah, you got all the way to the credits? Ah, professional novice. Right, it read the wrong string, but so what data does this have? Light pillar, children. Images, format, pillar, pound. Must have read the wrong data. Light pillar. Oh. Light pillar and unlit pillar. These belong up here. There. Minus 15, what? Oh, okay, so yeah, it was that re oh man. Sorry about that. I got that listed though, so I'll take a good look at why. Actually, let me put a comment on this bug right here. It also might just be crashing on huge. What level were you on, Hardboiled? Like what actual there's like levels 1 through 9. So what level were you on, and what was your world seed if you happen to remember? Because I'll note that here so I can try and go into your same world and see if it crashes for me, and hopefully that will. You level 5? Okay. Do you happen to know what world seed though? Right, so that should work now. Mars 2015/16. Mars powers a time traveler, everyone. If you didn't know that, the man travels through time. It's like the movie Continuum or the. Oh, what? Just noticed my seed was crazy there. Yeah, day 60. You can't chat from the future unless they change that in the future. Okay, I think there's light pillars right there that are not working. Or there's sconces. Sconce. Oh, it's probably because I don't have a sconce yet for those levels. Link, you were searching for Easter eggs? Nice. There aren't any Easter eggs yet, so. But there will be. There will definitely be Easter eggs. Cool, I got it noted what room you're in and all that, so hopefully I can find whatever's crashing there. You'd see YouTube content morph through time. There's a sconce thing for like one. Oh, here we go. I could just copy that. One sconce. Let's call this one two sconce. And I might have to repack these textures. Yeah. Oh, it did. No, I probably have to do it again. So assets, textures, common, remove that, and then rerun. And it should have this as a new texture here. Pedro, what's up? Yeah, could be the crafted top hat. Were you using that? And what kind of crafted top hat do you have, by the way? Pedro, thanks, man. Thank you. So Pedro's got a Steam controller, and I sent him a custom executable to try and get it working. It might be that Steam controllers need a special API because Steam has their own special API for it. So. Kind of looks weird, but it is expected. That's what's supposed to happen there. Oh, let's make sure the boss doors still work. Oh, boss door not working. What is repacking textures for? Every time I update a ping file. So all my images and stuff are stored in single ping files, right? And they all get packed together into a single texture or a single sprite sheet, it's called sometimes. But I use this program called Texture Packer for that. And it all happens on the command line for whenever I build my project. And it also happens I use Hammerspoon to do that if it detects the files change. One thing could be really useful. Jib should grab drop from mobs that happen on water to the nearest shore. Huh. Let's add that to the design as an idea. It's a fire top hat. Okay. Yeah, God mode. Yep. You've seen God mode before, right? Marza? The problem isn't the D-pad. The D-pad works fine, but the left joystick doesn't. Right, yeah, but I want to get it working for you. Okay, so it's oh, so all of your haptic feedback things work fine, but just not your left. Oh, so you're talking about Steam controller has this only as the single, right? The single joystick. So you're talking about just this little joystick thing here that's in the on the bottom left. And so if I understand you correctly, your whole D-pad and this other right side of the D-pad thingy, both of these work fine, but your joystick thing here does not. Is that right? Yeah, Marza, so why didn't you just use your top hat to get those items that dropped on the water? Okay. Oh, Pedro, that's way. Oh man, this could work then. If you send me the log text, it might just be that I'm ignoring some vector input or something like that. Because there's like three kinds of input that controllers can send or whatever. I am ignoring this one type of input that it might be sending that as right there. So that would be really cool to just boom, just enable that for you, and then bam, you'd be able to use that. So Pedro, what do you use this for typically? I know you probably have your own play style and stuff. So what is it that you use this little joystick for? Oh, it's your birthday. Happy birthday, Rocket Bunny. Oh, happy birthday, man. Dude, we need like a happy birthday gift or something for you right now. Yes. Which one you want, man? Why aren't any of these animating? Oh, the D-pad thing feels weird. Okay. Yeah, pizza. Rocket Bunny already won a Steam key last week. And I sent it to him, so he's good. He's playing the game and everything. He's got it. He won it. He won it from all his points. Happy birthday, Rocket Bunny. Right, boss doors aren't working. All right, but that's easy. It should be area creation. Yeah, so by the way, anybody who is watching the stream, if you're following the stream, like if you click the follow button or whatever, there's this little thing called Botfu, and he's awesome, and Boogie wrote him, and Botfu will track your watching minutes. So every minute that you watch the stream, you get a point. And then when you get up to 1,000 points, you can enter for a raffle. And you can win a copy of the game of Songbringer, and you can also win stickers eventually. I'll get stickers up there eventually too. Great boss. Oh, it's not boss door, it's boss something. Boss tile? Boss door tile? No, it's not. Great door. Big door. Maybe it's, I think it's create big door. Big, there it is. Yeah, Marza, totally. Yes. Yeah, absolutely. If you already own a copy of Songbringer, you can enter the raffle and win it anyways and give it to a friend. Or if you want, I'll send you a sticker too. Same thing. Rocket Bunny, yes, I didn't know my internet did not get better. Unfortunately, my internet is still slow uploading. But I changed the settings on game show so that they're less quality. So it still should be a little tiny bit blurry for you guys to read my text, but at least you can kind of read it, right? Marza. Oh, okay, good. Hard-boiled egg, good to know. Thank you, man. That's got to be it then. It's got to be that. Yeah, so It has something to do with how the fire top hat and the fire bomb, they like spew tons of sprites everywhere. And I think I'm exceeding the number of sprites that are, or something's going on like that. You're poor again. Oh yeah, you go, yeah, exclamation point help, and it tells you all the commands. But I think it's exclamation point raffle or something like that. Super Zelda Melee Bros. Yeah, there you go. Oh yeah, command. Yeah, exclamation steam key. That's right. Exclamation time travel. All right, so it's gonna get the data for the boss door, and then it's gonna process it somehow. Maybe not. All right, yeah, we got a boss doors again. What's going on over here? Oh, this is like a really sunken tile. Lightning bomb! The lightning bombs seem to work. They're not crashing the game right now. That's good to know. You just rock a whole room full of enemies. Alright, good. It looks like every entity is now restored back to kind of how it was for level two. Let's go. I'm gonna go back to level one and make sure those entities are looking good. Oh, hard-boiled egg. All you gotta do is just watch. All you have to do is be following and watch. That's it. All right, let's make sure all these entities are working again here. Level one. I got anchor points on. Turn anchor points off. Wait, what? Yeah, Rocket Bunny, of course. How many points do I have? Weetabix, what's up, man? This is kind of bugging me. I wonder why there's a little pink dot right there. Oh, the statues are not working right here. Want to see if the anims. What's up, Cynical Director? Is C++ easier to learn than Java? Not really, probably not. What's up, Regonite? Would it be easy to do a branching story text game? Kind of. The trick about story text games is that you have to parse what people say, right? You're talking about like a game where you type things in and it can it can understand what you're trying to say. Is that what you're talking about? Oh, that's not an anchor point. Maybe I'd change the graphic. Pillar. This is the one pillar. 0, 1, 2. Like Scribble Knots? I haven't played Scribble Knots. Yeah, Boogie's got some great advice right there. If you're interested at all in any kind of C-based language, C is probably the first language you should learn. Because it'll teach you how to do memory. It'll teach you how pointers work. Oh, you mean it gives you options, you select one, it changes the whole... Oh, like a choose-your-own-adventure book. Yeah, that would probably be pretty easy. You just, you know, the branching part, you would have to write some branching code it would probably help to put all your data in a text file or some kind of data file. Yeah, it's totally doable. Okay, I don't know why there's a pink dot on those, but I'm just going to ignore it for now. Render component. Render component. Oh, it's not even doing this. Oh, maybe it has a child. Pillars. Maybe pillars accidentally have some kind of child. Entities. Pillar. If I do that, it should no longer have a pillar. Yeah, you've always been interested in writing novels? Cool, man. That's awesome. Have you written any like short stories or anything like that? Oh, that's the problem. It's the light pillar. Okay. Oh, and it's glow. Yeah, there's the problem. Okay, so the light pillar for the first dungeon. Just got to change that up. Area creation. You're working on your own Java API? Cool. Oh, cool. Java GGL. Cool, man. Does the CXC only log the buttons it doesn't recognize? No, it'll log every button. Yeah, it'll log every button, every axis, and every vector, and every POV. Like, basically any kind of input that it can possibly get, it should be logging. Ah. What's up, the law? Welcome, welcome, welcome. So this light pillar has a glow key, which is... Oh. This needs to be if kit... sprite frame exists for glow key, then we turn off the fire. Any cool updates to Valtry? Not yet. No, there haven't been any really. The one thing I'm thinking of changing is changing the names of get child to be get leaf instead of get child. What do you think about that? All right, good. We got flames on the top of these now. And back in level 2, should still have regular light pillars, still have their own glowing thing. Yeah, hard-boiled egg. If you want to go windowed mode, set your settings to window size. Go movie is pretty big. It's like 1080p. There's also what other options you have? You have movie. Oh, I think there's medium, small, or tiny. I think those are all the options. Right? So I would do movie if you want to do a nice big one, or maybe medium. But yeah, so those are options should work for you. And once again, I'm going to be adding this to the main menu so you can actually change your window size and change your, change stuff that's important. Right? Yeah, since it's a tree. Oh. So you think child is more coherent? Okay. Maybe I won't change it then. Yeah, hardball, cool, man. I see what's going on. So if it doesn't have this glow key, then it's just gonna make it empty. That'll get rid of that freaking pink dot finally. Was bugging me, little pink dot. Yo, Thomas, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm tired too. I'm already getting hungry. Like I said at the beginning of the stream, it might be a short stream today, guys. I got a lot of bugs to fix tonight and food to eat to keep me going. So good. Okay, that's working now. Let's get these statues working once again. Statue tile. Oh, it's gonna be its image file name probably. Statues dungeon. Wonder why the other one worked. Oh, a get leaf would be a terminal node only. I hear you. That would be an interesting one. You're playing Game Dev Tycoon? Cool. I know, right? Yeah, it might be kind of overkill to add that method. Yeah, so far Mars of Power, Valtry is working awesome. Yeah, thanks again for your help on that and getting like especially getting the query function. The query function is look at this. I mean, I use this all the time now. I mean, yeah, it's so good. So I haven't really done anything since I incorporated your stuff and did some few like performance and improvements. And since then, man, Valtry's just been kicking ass. I love it. I use it like all the time for everything now. Yeah, totally. Plus, query is so good. Look at it. I'm using it right here. World. Okay, so I'm gonna use get any entity data for statue dungeon. Or get any data for statue. Oh, but this is gonna be different. This is gonna be maybe formatted here. It's not logging the D-pad nor the joystick. Damn. It's not logging the D-pad or the joystick, but it works. Oh, Pedro, sucks, man. I must have bummed up something wrong. I did something wrong for when I sent you the code for that updated exe. Let me take a look here. Input controllers. Hey, what's up, Sadoff? Just working on bugs, man. Oh, really? Oh, hard-boiled. Wow, thank you, man. Oh, you know what? It might be because I just changed it today to make it so it repositions the window in the when in the full mode. So it might be that. So if your D-pad is working, Pedro, it probably means that you're using it's I wish I knew. Wait, oh, Pedro, it would be really nice to know what you got at the top of your log file. At the top of your log file, it will tell something like this. It'll have the OIS version, the total number of for each joystick, it'll go the ID, the number of axes, the number of sliders, the number of that stuff. So if you tell me that right now, can you post that on the stream real quick? Because this little information would really help me know what part to look at here in the code. Sweet. What's up? Welcome everybody. Welcome to the stream. This game's called Songbringer, and I'm just working on bugs right now. Okay, so back to this. Yeah, this is gonna be kit string with format. Oh, cool. So Pedro's got total keyboards one, total mice, total joysticks, joystick one, ID zero, axes five. Five axes. Zero sliders, one POV, 10 buttons, zero vector threes. That was the one thing I was hoping it might be, the vector threes. Let me look at the Steam controller again. So if it has five axes, this is one, this is two. I'm imagining this is three and this is four. Yeah, five must be something else. Like maybe it's, I don't know. I don't know what five is. Yeah, so this is not an axie or not an axis at all. This joystick here, and it's not a vector three. You know what, Pedro? It might be that the vector three. Might be that the Vector 3 code doesn't work yet for the Steam controller. Man, how would I fix that? I guess I have to kind of shoot. I might have to implement the well. I'll put a bug here on the Trello about this. So, get Steam controllers. Single joystick to work. And some notes. Five axes, zero sliders, one POV. I wonder what the one POV is. Would be the POV? And maybe this is the POV here. But then it would totally be working for you. I don't know why. And you got 10 buttons. Zero vector threes. Okay, and some more notes. D-pad things work. Little joystick doesn't. Might need to upgrade OIS and or implement Steam Controller API. All right, I got it noted. I got that bug noted. I don't know what to do here. As when you map the PS2 controller and then try to play with the Steam controller and the joystick. Oh, you mean when you plugged in your PS2 controller, mapped it, and then played with the Steam controller, and it worked? But everything else didn't work. Oh, that would make sense that it wouldn't work. Oh my gosh. Okay, so Pedro, can you email me your saves.txt then? I want to look at your bindings. So in your bind, you'll have like in your saves.txt, you'll have like a section called bindings, and the ones that start with all these like hexadecimal characters, those are your bindings for your controllers. And so I wonder how it actually mapped. Yeah, I don't know if that'll, I'm not sure how much that'll help though to know this information. But regardless, I'd like to get to the bottom of this so you can play it how you would prefer to. Code monkeys. The chat's back on the stream? Yeah, that's because yesterday I was streaming with OBS. What are my marketing tactics for once the game is released? Well, my marketing tactics started way before the game was released, and that's probably the biggest mistake I made with my last video game, was trying to market everything after making it. It's a horrible way to make a game. It's like trying to build up a momentum and a following after you've already made your game. Is a really bad idea. It's very, very difficult. So really, marketing starts with day one, I believe, in a project. The very first day you're making your game, you should be sharing it and starting to build a following. And I put all this in my Gamma Sutra article, so if you want to check that out, but yeah, once the game's released, like I said, that's also going to be before the game's released. So my marketing tactics for when about release time is for, a good 2 or 3 months before that, I'll be prepping the game, prepping the marketing materials, which includes like I'll make an updated video. I need to make a way better video. So the video right now is, it's okay, but there could be a lot. I want to add more story to the video and add more emotional swings and like I want to make the trailer video like a kind of an emotional roller coaster, just something that really, really catches the player. Because it's probably the one of the most important things you can have for marketing your game is your video, your trailer. And then second behind that is probably your screenshots. And so I need to have awesome screenshots, awesome video, have all of the everybody prepped and everybody knows basically that it's coming out, including all of y'all fans, as well as, people in the press and things like that. And then just let it launch, man. See how well it does. Yeah, the pad is a touchpad. Right? You want me to map both? You could try mapping both controllers. I don't know what would happen when you did that. Yeah. It's cool, pizza. Yeah, not only does marketing early on get followers, but also encourages the creator to push themselves to make the game better and better for all their backers. Totally, Rega. Yeah, there's so many benefits to sharing your game from the get-go. And the only thing that was stopping me from sharing my game was fear. I was like, oh my gosh, people are going to steal my ideas. But people, I found out that people don't technically do that really. And if they do try and steal your idea, they're probably not going to do a very good job of it. So it's really not that much to worry about. It's kind of an irrational fear. That should be okay. This is no longer needed as a note. Yeah, you agree? Cool. Yeah, totally. It goes way deeper than just 10 minutes per screenshot. I mean, you could spend you I've spent a whole week just working on screenshots before. I think not for Songbring. I've probably only worked like 2 days or more. Yeah, the last time I did screenshots, I worked for like 3 days, and I think I did a whole bunch of screenshots, and I recorded all these sections for the video. So yeah, it's a lot of work. Marketing is a lot of work, and it's a lot of work that's really not. It doesn't seem like you're working on your game, but you really are. Marketing work is so important. Yeah, Epic MC, what's up, man? It's been a few years working a game now, but I'm afraid of showing anything exactly because I don't want people to steal my idea. Totally, dude. Totally. So here, Epic, I do have a piece of advice for you. Yes, yeah, Epic, I do. I totally recommend that. I totally recommend that. But first of all, before you do that, I would recommend this first. There, let me check out this link. This might help. It might not. But I wrote this article called Tuning the Mind, and it's all about this. It's all about dealing with the little fears you have before you like, because you can tra the thing is, you could transform these fears into actual power. Like you could make basically there's things that are blocking you right now. They're stopping you from sharing your game, and it's a bad thing. You need to be sharing your game, and it will you'll kick ass, dude. You'll start building a following and probably no one's going to steal your ideas. So it's, but the thing is, if you tune your mind and you deal with it and you like get down to the core causes of why you're afraid of that and kind of deal with it on a personal, like soul searching kind of level, you can unlock yourself in ways. And I don't know. Let me share this with you on the Twitch. 'Cause this is probably the most important thing that helped me before I started Songbringer. So maybe this helps you too. Mars, am I getting positive feedback for Songbringer? Tons, man. More than I ever expected. You seen a streamer who streamed the actual gameplay, but when he went into coding, he made his screen blurred? Oh. What? Why would they eat you alive? Oh, and it was a mod anyways? Crazy. King Nothing sounds like some California hippie. Right? I am a total California hippie, but really that I mean that sincerely. I totally mean that sincerely. That is, it's very important to deal with your fears and to transform them into beliefs that are positive, you know, basically fears are just negative beliefs and they can be transformed into positive beliefs, which will propel you forward. What's up, two gamers? One of the mental blockades I have is that I don't think the game is ready to be shown yet. All right. I totally hear you there too. I totally hear you there, man. I had the exact same fears, the same two fears. One, okay, if I just have a simple brown screen, that's not enough to show people. And I was afraid of that. And then I finally got over it. And you could see, if you look at my YouTube account, it's got every day's video of making this game. The very first day, all I had was a brown screen. And I was honestly scared to share that. But I got over it. And getting over it was one of the most important things to make this game happen. Because if I hadn't got over it, I wouldn't have built a following. I wouldn't have done a Kickstarter. I wouldn't have got the Kickstarter to succeed, and then I never would have made this game. So honestly, those simple two little fears would have completely stopped this game from working. It would have never gotten this far. Yeah, TJall, you're irrationally worried about a lot of things. Totally, it's irrational fears. We all have them. You know, we all totally have them. Yeah, Marza has. Marza was the third backer. He was. We had a little like contest going to see who could back first. You can say me about game? What? Yeah, Rega Knight. Good call. He sees it. If someone wants to steal his idea, you got a damn good idea. I agree, man. Yeah. Yeah. I know, King Nothing. See, you guys like the brown screens. That's the thing, right? I might have been like worried about you guys seeing a brown screen, like, oh, this game is not ready to share. But really, those are the things that you guys wanted to see. And it really is. The more you show your vulnerable side to people, the more they will trust you. The more, and it's true, because you have to bare your soul to be to put your creations out, you know. So it's it the universe rewards you for basically for putting yourself in those vulnerable situations. So your fear is you're putting everything in this game, but it won't be good. Pizza. I hear you there, man. I hear you totally. Yeah. And you know, one way to get over that is just to keep making your game. And eventually, like that happened with Songbringer. I was afraid that it wouldn't be that great of a game and that no one would want to back it and all that. But the more I live streamed and the more I developed it, it was over the first like 4 months of the game's development. I got more and more confident because people kept coming onto my stream and saying, "Hey, your art looks good." I was like, "Really? The art looks good?" Because I was not really an artist at that point. So, yeah, all I'm saying is keep going, and you'll get over your fears. Trust yourself instead. Yeah. Oh, well, there's the problem. It doesn't have an image format for that. Oh, empty data. Statue dungeon. Right, so I'm in the process of moving some entities from world.txt into entities.txt, this new format. Cool, Bappy Buppy. Yeah, I'm glad you're enjoying this topic. I really think it's probably one of the most important topics I can ever talk about. So thanks for bringing it up, Epic MC. Yeah, Epic, you can do it, man. Don't worry. Yeah, you'll get it, dude. I'm so glad you're encouraged because now you're gonna be on a new path. I'm excited to see where you go. So, you know, it would be nice to know how you do, man. So I would love it if you check back and you know, maybe a month from now or whatever, whenever. Just say how it went. You know, be cool to know. Oh, you can't make it work with your PS2 bindings again? Oh, man. Oh, Rocket Bunny, if you want to change the window size, just go to your settings. So you go to your saves.txt file and you change your window size setting. It's going to start off as full. You got options. You could change it to be full screen. You can also do like windowed mode. Movie is one of the windowed modes. But like I said earlier, this is going to be an actual setting in the game's menu, but for now it's just a text setting. Yeah, pizza, nice. Yeah, Thomas. Can you spoil the full story inside Stomper? What do you mean? Spoil it, like figure it all out. So Rega, I always had an interest in game development, but I never really wanted to make a game. Right? Nice, Rega, cool. Nice, man. That's awesome. I'm glad. I'm glad you're in that state, 'cause man, this could be something huge for you. You never know. I've completed the game multiple times next year. So we're looking for Statue Dungeon. What happened to the statues? Here's one. Oh. Oh, okay, so it looks like I accidentally deleted the statue dungeon. Me see what the difference is between these files, because I lost one of these. Does he ever find John and Ren? You're under NDA? That's crazy. I didn't know I was going to make you sign an NDA. Gosh, the things you learn when you talk to time travelers. Okay, here's my uncommitted changes. What happened? Oh, entities, world. Okay, so world. I must have like deleted the statue dungeon entity from some one of these. Oh, there it is. I wonder why it's not there. Oh, maybe I just didn't move it from world yet. Oh, there's statue, bush, tile. They're dead, I just know it. What's up, PMC? Turns out he was just stoned the whole time. So there's statue dungeon. This needs an at sign there and a pound sign there. World, there's a couple more things to move. These, the entrance to level 3. Entrance 3. This is entrance dungeon 3. Statue. Bush. Oh, the bushes are totally different. Have I already developed the gravitational switch? No. Cool to know that I will, though. It's a psychedelic bush. This is going to be messed up for a minute. All right, so now Statue Dungeon should work if I make it use a different kind of format. So it's going to be image file as image as that format, but then this format image file name with the frame number. Oh, that's gonna be R. Yeah, that should work. What about the quantum entangled dual lightsaber? Dude, the stuff that is going to be in this game, so awesome. So is the cactus item in Songbringer based on DMT? It's based on mescaline. Yeah. It's kind of a mescaline-y thing. You map the direction keys and then use the Steam big picture to map those to the controller. It worked then? Cool. Nice workaround, Pedro. Let me note that. Let me put this in the bugs here. So, Steam controller workaround solution. Map the direction keys to the keyboard. And then use Steam big picture mode to map those to the Steam controller. All right, cool. Workaround solution noted. Thanks, Pedro. Nice find. So, do we have statues now? All right, cool. Statues are working again. Oh no, their collision's not working though. That's easy. Oh man, statue and statue dungeon are the same thing now. You're trying to generate a radial gradient. Should be black around the corners, huh? Offhand. What's up, Gutting? Okay, so now these work? Yeah, okay, we can walk around these now. They have proper collision. It's good. But now these are the same thing. It's like unnecessary to put two different kinds of statues and data and two different statues here. Oh, this is, okay, so this should be smarter. Yeah, so this could just be world get any data statue. And if the area's formatting method, this format method needs to be smarter for its area pods.z. Oh man. Yeah, this needs its own, it needs a Z function here. The bed is calling. Is the next version is yeah, it's alpha version 2. And then the version okay, so yeah. Alpha version 2 is gonna be this Wednesday, and then the beta version is gonna be February 21st this year, and that's exactly 30 years to the day from the release of Zelda 1. So I could do some honor there to Zelda 1. Yeah, totally. If you want to upgrade your pledge, totally, you're totally welcome to do that. Upgrading your pledge to get the alpha version, you would get your name in gold, and your name would be up high in the credits. Or you know, your option, you can always just wait till beta too, and beta will be February 21st, and then that's $32 cheaper. Oh yeah, this area format method needs a Z. What's up, Born Snipe? So the default is going to work as it used to, give passing in the area pods.z. And then this is going to pass in. So area pause.z is 0. Then we're going to use the get flag number from it automatically. This get flag number. Otherwise, we're just going to use area pause.z. Will there be a PS5 version? What's up? Yo, I'm the Orchid Man. Are they really? Are they really moving away from the PlayStation brand? What are XML files? They're just a data format. It's kind of like HTML. Nightmare, that's what they are. what's up, Wissiso? Nice, Rega. Thanks, man. Or are they? It's called PlayStation Now. PlayStation?
Sorry, so I went to the store and forgot tomatoes and cucumbers. So I have to go back to the store in order to get salad stuff. Unless you want to go after you then.
No. I'm not going anywhere. Commodore 64, golden days. You launch the game and pray that it will load correctly. Today's games, right? Gotta update them and stuff. I wanna see how that works with this format. That's yes. The wizard had foo. She's awesome. I love my lady. Okay, key, statue, data, children. Yeah, this is all good. Image file name. Right. Now that becomes one statue 0. Good. Is my blacktop? Yes, yes, Wissiso, it is. And so the latest OS X, El Capitan, has that option. It's just in your preferences and all that. Stores come to Wizard Poo. I'm just having one of those days. I need rest and stuff. I can't go to the store right now. Okay, so there's the problem. This is supposed to be... God, maybe I do need statue versus statue dungeon. Yeah, hopefully they will. What about a world without pollution? Please. Come on, we need cleaner power. That's all we need. These are the zero statues. A two has its own special statue though. It has a 0-2. Maybe it's two statue. Oh, yeah, 0-2 statue 0. If that's not confusing, what is? Yeah. Man, I broke so many things yesterday writing this new code. Right at the wrong time. It's a bad time to try and do new stuff when you're trying to, get a release out. I got so many bugs that I can't even get to, like all these bugs on the code on the Trello, that I'm stopped. I can't even do anything until I work on those, until I finish this. Man, I'm not sure exactly how to fix this one. Guess I do need a statue dungeon. Yeah, that's it. Statue dungeon. Okay, so entities, statue, where'd it go? Yeah, there's statue and then statue dungeon. So statue is gonna be 0 at statue number, and then statue dungeon is just gonna be at statue. Yeah, really? Is that how it works with IGN? I did not know that. Yeah, but it's true. It's kind of how that business works. Some people basically take bribes to. To get reviews. That's how it worked when I worked at this one company in back in the 2000s. I remember our marketing dude actually sending money to somebody so that they would write an article. I mean, it's not really I guess it's not technically a bribe. It's just, they're just getting paid to write the article, Just slip them a Gibson. Right, Marza, good night, man. Statue is gonna be this is gonna be statue dungeon. That's gonna be statue. All right, let's try this again. No, it doesn't have any statues here, but that's because we need like statues for all the dungeons. Look at that! Oh, it's been a minute. Yeah, look at that. That's a huge Beastie Warrior train we got going. This level's looking pretty good. I miss this old world seed though. I had this seed thing on for so long. Nobody wants to chat now. Nobody wants to break it. All right, I'm trying to get it fixed for the statues and the overworld. It would be like, it's the stat. This the regular statue uses zero, and then the number of the dungeon. You're counting to 30. I guess I could have a fallback image. So, like, statue format would be this. Fallback would be statue. So if kit count sprite frames image file name equals data.query images.fallback. Let's see what happens. Yes, it is. It's the new 2016 record. You got some more finding related to the Steam controller? Okay. Thanks, Pedro. Yeah, of course, man. Of course, pizza. Okay, so image file name starts off as this format here. Oh, but it's going to need to... It's going to be image file name equals format. So we need to go world format style or something. Yeah, format style, given format. Whoa. Format style and given the format and area pause.z. And then count the number of sprite frames for the format. And then if that doesn't work, then the backup format becomes the fallback. And then if format.size less than zero, I think this will kind of work. Yeah, Epic, of course, man. You could do a straw poll for that. That's what we usually do for voting, is like a straw poll. Have you seen those? It's just strawpoll.me. It's a really simple, easy way to do a poll. Damn. Let's see if it worked in here. Ah, yeah, it's working here. Something's wrong up here, though. All right, so format is zero at statue number. Just adding a style to that becomes 00. Oh, that's wrong. That's supposed to be get flag number. So format becomes statue number. And the image file becomes statue zero. And that's an invisible render component. Oh. Okay. So it looks like there are no zero statues or blank statues. I think it's just one statue. It should be the fallback. Yeah, zero statue. That's it. Everything else works. Yeah, PMC. I remember you talking about that. Yeah, the video game words were crazy. So it should be Z here. Int Z equals that. This should be format style Z. And back in entities.text, statue, regular statue, fallback, zero. Oh man, that would have been so great if it just got rid of the at automatically. All right, Hardboiled, see you, man. Yeah, good night. Finally worked. Finally have some statues on the overworld. Game development studio name. Oh, I like brain damage. Definitely brain damage. That's my vote. Okay, next entity needs to get working. Light pillar. Man, I'm getting low on blood sugar levels, I think. Starting to run out of energy, guys. I don't know if I can stream much longer. Let's do one more entity though. Area creation. It was the light pillar tile. You liked it the most too? Nice. You know, I think studio names like that work really well because otherwise they're not memorable. You know, only the only studio names you remember are the ones that are memorable, right? Of course, it makes sense. So, you know, like Vlambeer, I always thought it was a weird name and it was memorable. And it was the same kind of thing. It was like a totally whimsical name for them to name their company Vlambeer. So I think having some kind of like hook like that in your name is really, really works. So yeah, this is now a light pillar. Oh, I need to just move basically the regular light pillars. There's a one light pillar. It's one pillar. So what are the entity names again? Entity light pillar. Oh yeah, so it's based on the at pillar. Also would be awesome if this could just fall back, but it doesn't. But anyways, pillar. So I'm gonna go sheets, common, pillar, yeah, and all these need to be zero. So that's in raw sheets, common, move pillar. Nice pizza. In primitive mode, you shouldn't need to kill all the mobs to get the key card of a room. Why is that? Why would you not want that? Because it will be called speedrun mode and not permadeath. But yeah, I'm still not seeing why you would want to do that. Because really, in speed runs, you still are completing the game as, I mean, usually, unless there's a bug, you usually, are the point of the speed run is to see how fast you can do the game. So I don't see why you would want to make it easier in permadeath mode. Double W's? I kind of like that. Yeah, double W's is actually memorable as well. Double W's, that's the kind of thing you put question marks above your head. Double W's? What? So, assets, textures, common, PVR. So run that again. Hopefully that'll make the regular pillars better. It's not easier if each mob does 2 times the damage. Yeah. I see what you're saying. I don't know if I want to change the actual gameplay though in permadeath. Good, we got pillars again. Good. All right, so that's it for today's stream. I gotta get some food in my belly. I'm starting to get woozy here. So yeah, I really appreciate you guys though. Thanks again for watching, and thanks. Oh, thanks especially so much for all your great feedback on the game. You started hitting the pillar hoping to get the key, and then I had to kill all of them. Yeah. Okay. I hear you. I mean, I'll think about it for sure, but at this point, I'd really like to keep the game play this pretty much the same in permadeath versus regular mode. So, yeah, good night, everybody. Have a great night. I'm glad the stream worked today. That was pretty cool to have this working in, like, even if it was lower quality, at least it works. So, cheers, everybody. Yeah, thank you.